Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Ram, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Hare.
Stam sthapitam jena bhutale svayam rupa kadamayam dadati sva padantikam vandeyaham sri guram sri juta padakamalam Sri Gurun Vaishnavanscha Sri Rupam Sagrajatam Sahagana Raghunatha Nitam Tam Sajivam Sadvaitam Savadhutam Parijana Sahitam Krishna Chaitanya Devam Sri Radha Krishna Padan Sahagana Lalita Sri Visakha Nitangsa Bansha Kalpataru Bhasha Ribasindhu Bhaivacha Patitanang Pavanibhyo Vaishnavibhyo Nama Namaha Namavam Vishnu Padaya Krishna Prasthaya Bhutale Srimate Bhakti Vedanta Swamine Iti Namine Namaste Saraswati Deve Gauravani Pracharine Nirvishesha Sunnabadi Paschatya Desatarine He Krishna Karuna Sindhu Dina Bandhu Jagatpate Gopesha Gopika Kanta Radha Kanta Namastute Tapta Kanchana Gaurangi Radha Vrinda Baneshwari Vrishabhanu Sute Devi Pranamami Hari Priye Jaya Sri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda Sri Advaita Gadadhar Sri Vasadi Sri Gaura Bhakta Vrinda Hare Krishna Hare Krishna 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 Hare 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 Rama Hare Rama 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 Hare
Mukam Karati Vachalang Pangulang Hayati Giring Jatkripat Mahang Bande Paramananda Madhavam Siguru Dinatayanang Sri Chaitanya Iswaram So today we will continue discussing on Srimati Radharani because we get this great opportunity once a year to discuss about Radharani. Before celebrating her auspicious appearance day, after a few days we will celebrate. So yesterday I had discussed about Radharani. Who is Radharani? What she is made up of? She is made up of Krishna Prema. Her whole body is made up of that. So that we understand her real positions. So we do not miscalculate about her position. Then the greatness of her love for Krishna. That also in Chaitanya Charitamrita Krishna Das Kaviraj Goswami very vividly describing. The greatness of Radharani's love for Krishna. So, she is deriving pleasure by serving Krishna, not only by serving Krishna, by seeing Krishna is happy, she feels happy. Her happiness is when she sees Krishna is happy. Then she feels ananda. And how much unalloyed her love for Krishna. In this material world, we are trying to get some kind of ananda by developing loving relationship, to our house, to our family members, to our country, to our community. But whatever ananda we are receiving, there is material ananda, known as jodananda. Starting from here all the way to Satyaloka where Brahma is residing, one can achieve this jodananda. And higher than jodananda is Brahmananda. The different kinds of ananda. Higher than jodananda is Brahmananda. The karmakandis, they get jodananda, promoting themselves to higher planetary systems. And jnanakandis, they get Brahmananda. They go beyond Satyaloka or Brahmaloka. They cross the 8 layers of this material world. They cross Biraja River. They go to Brahma Jyoti, where they receive Brahmananda. And what is this Brahmananda? This Brahmananda is nothing but the absence of material misery. They are not getting some extra ananda out of it or bliss, but there is absence of material sufferings. That is Brahmananda. So in this way, Brahmananda is higher than Jadananda. So higher than Brahmananda is Premananda. The devotees of Krishna, they derive. That is known as Premananda. But there is something more higher than Premananda also. I have already. So higher than Premananda. What is the higher than Premananda? How can be something there higher than Krishna Prem? Krishna Prem is Pancham Purusartha, Prema Pumartha Mahan Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhur Matamidam Tatradru Naparaha. Prem is the highest goal of life. So there is something more than Premananda also. So Jadananda, Brahmananda, Premananda, then higher than Premananda is Sevananda. Krishnadas Kaviraj Goswami describing that how when devotees of Krishna serving to Krishna, or gopis are fanning Krishna, they're decorating their face very nicely. They're decorating their face very nicely, dressing very nicely. They're putting all kinds of ornament very nicely, not for their sense gratification, just to give pleasure to Krishna. But when they're serving Krishna, then Krishna Prema arises. When Krishna Prema arises, then what happens? The symptoms of Krishna Prema, tears comes from their eyes, body starts to tremble, was stunned. So that time the gopis are saying, "Oh Prem, you please stay away from us. Don't disturb us in our service." The point is their mood of service so unalloyed, so pure. So the symptoms of Krishna Prem, they are saying, "You please wait. No, only service. That's it." So that is swarup of Srimati Radharani. And also yesterday I discussed, explain to you why her name is Radharani, then how she appeared in Golok Vrindavan from body of Lord Krishna. Achaitanya Charitamrita explains, Radha Krishna Pranay Vikriti Hladini Shakti Rasmat Ekatmana Vapi Bhuvipura Dehabhedham Gatauto Ek Atma. They are one. Just like you cannot separate the whiteness from the milk. Milk and whiteness of milk cannot be separated. They are one. You cannot separate sun rays from sun, sunshine from sun. They are one. That is way we have to understand the identity of Radha and Krishna. But Bhuvipura Dehabhedam Gatoto, since time immemorial, they have received two separate bodies. I explained to you how the Shakti is there in a murta, in amurta within Krishna and murta form outside Krishna. So today we will discuss now this session to why Radharani has to come to this material world. I had discussed yesterday the different reasons that creates a reason for Krishna to come to this earthly planet. There is a Anusanga Gauna Karan, secondary reason. You remember? What is the secondary reason Krishna comes to this material world? Who remembers? Yes? Paritranaya sadhanang vinasacha duskritang dharma sansthapanarthaya. What is the primary reason that any incarnation comes to this material world? What is the primary reason? Yes? To? No. Why any incarnation comes? To give bhakti. Bhakti yoga vidhanartham katham pasyam he astriya kunti devi saying. And also, to give pleasure. Mad bhakta vinodartham karami vividha kriya. To give pleasure. Then one more reason. Anugraha bhaktanang manusim tanumasritam bhajate tadrisakrita jasrutva tatapara bhavet. He will exhibit his sweet pastimes. By hearing his sweet pastimes, the living entities will be attracted to him to go back to Godhead. Three reasons. Mukhya karan. Three main reasons. To give bhakti yoga. To give pleasure to his devotees. And he will exhibit his sweet pastimes. Jasrutva tatapara bhavet. By hearing those pastimes, the living entities will be attracted towards him to go back to Godhead. Ever any incarnations comes. So any of you remember why Krishna comes? I described yesterday very elaborately that why Krishna has to come, he is Swayam Bhagavan. Etitansa Kalapansa Krishna to Bhagavan Swayam. He has to come all the way from Golok Vrindavan. He has to come only if something is there that no other incarnation can do. Paritrinaya sadhunang vinasacha duskritam, to give bhakti yoga, any incarnation can do. But only Krishna will come to this material world if there is something no other incarnation can do except him, only he can do it. To test the... Yes, to release. To release prema bhak, prema rasa nirjasa karite aswadana. To release the prema rasa, the essence of prema rasa. The essence of the prema rasa. And one more reason. Raga marga bhakti loke karite pacharana. To preach among the people about raga marga bhakti. Spontaneous. Loving, love for Krishna. So these two things. So why Krishna has to do these two things? Raga marga bhakti loke karite pracharana. Because rasika sekhara Krishna parama karuna ei dui hetu ichchara udgama. Why Krishna develops these two desires? We have to justify. Who develops desires? If you don't have something, you develop desire to get. If you have, then you should not have any desire. Only when you need something, want something, the desire comes. If you don't want anything, then desire comes? No. But Krishna is aptakama, is fully satisfied. He should not have any desires like us, because he has everything. So why these two desires develops within Krishna? That I don't release the essence of prema and distribute ragamarga bhakti. That is because in his swarup, his rasika sakhara Krishna parama karuna ei dui hetu ichchara udgama. Because of these two reasons, he developing desire. In his swarup, his rasika sakhara. The topmost personality to release the mela is made up mela rasavai saha. I have discussed this subject matter yesterday. That is one reason. Because rasika sakhara, he want to release the essence of mela. And why he wants to disturb Raga Marga Bhakti? Because he is Parama Karuna. He is very merciful. He is very merciful. Krishna saying, Aishwarya Shithila Preme Nahi Mara Priti. I do not enjoy from that love, which love is reduced by the influence of Aishwarya or opulence. He doesn't enjoy out of that. So, being very merciful to the people in general, Lord Krishna comes once in one day of Brahma to distribute a special kind of bhakti known as Raga Bhakti. These two regions that Krishna created in this material world. Then, what happens in spiritual world? When Rama comes, Vamana comes, for all incarnations, they create some excuse there in spiritual world also. I'll tell you that. Once, Srimati Radharani was serving Krishna in Rasamandala, in Golok Vrindavan. In Rasamandala, Golok Vrindavan, there is Satasringha mountain. That Satasringha mountain manifests here on this earthly planet as Giri Govardhan. So in Rasamandala, so Radharani is serving Krishna. And when she was serving Krishna, she got so much ecstasy, so much bliss out of service to Krishna, and she fainted. When Radharani fainted, that time Krishna, he left Radharani, and Krishna went to meet another Sakhi or Gopi, Biraja. He went to take service from Biraja. He went to Biraja's Kunja. And after some time, Radharani, she came back to external consciousness, and she found Krishna is not there. Now she is deprived of serving Krishna. And she is feeling so much pain. Now Krishna is not here. Where is Krishna? Then her Sakhi said, Krishna has gone to Biraja's Kunja to take service from her. What? How can she dare to serve Krishna? What she knows? To serve Krishna? Because for Radharani, she is not envious of other, she is not envious of Chandravali Biraja. What her concern is, she is not envious of other gopis if they serve Krishna. But what her concern is, that she knows that definitely Krishna, when he is taking service from others, he is not enjoying so much. So that was her concern. Her concern is not out of enviousness. She is thinking, oh, why Krishna went there? Why they are enjoying with Krishna? Not like that. She would be happy if others can give more pleasure, enjoyment to Krishna. She would have no problem. But her concern is, Krishna is not definitely enjoying so much. So why that disturbing Krishna? Then Radharani is saying, oh, Krishna has gone to Biraja's Kunja. Let me go and see how she is serving Krishna. Actually, she was very upset. She was very angry also. She picked up a stick in her hand. And she has a huge chariot. And she told all her sakhis, all of you come with me. You know how many sakhis she has to help in service to Krishna? Huh? How many? And that 1 billion gopis, they come for Rasalila. That is only 1 billion, they join in Rasalila here in Vrindavan. But there, she has 630 million sakhis. Yes, Purana says that. She has 630 million sakhis to help her to serve Krishna. And she told all of them, you come with me. And such huge chariot. Brahma Vaivarta Purana explains, describes the beautiful chariot. How it is decorated, how many wheels it has. It is so big chariot. Inside the chariot, there are many, many big palaces are there. The gardens, fountain, mountains, lakes, rivers, everything there. Inside that chariot. And that chariot goes at speed of mind. So all these 633 million sakhis, then Radharani went to the Kunja, where Biraja Devi was serving Krishna. So Krishna was there inside with Biraja. And Krishna told Sridham that you stand here outside. Don't allow anybody inside. Especially if Radharani comes, don't let her come inside. Then Krishna was there inside the Kunja group, taking service from Biraja. Then in the meantime Radharani arrived there. Then Radharani asked, Sridham, where is your friend Krishna? Sridham said, oh, I don't know where he is. He is not here. Then Radharani saying, he is not here, then what are you doing here? No, I am just loitering here. No, you are here means Krishna must be here. So let me go inside the Kunja sea. No, I'll go inside the Kunja. Then Sridham, he became very worried. He said, no, you can't go inside. Radharani, no, I'll go inside. But Sridham is very, very muscular body, you know. Very palwan. Huh? He said, no, you can't go inside. Then Radharani, how can you dare to stop me? Then she has only 630 million sakhis. She told them, please take care of Sridham. They picked him up and put him in one side. So when all this talking is going on there, then from inside, Biraja could hear. Biraja heard that Radharani is there. And Biraja, when she heard Radharani has come, Krishna heard. Krishna and Biraja both heard Radharani has come. When Krishna came to know Radharani has come, immediately he disappeared from there. And Biraja is alone. And Biraja got so scared, so out of fear of Radharani, she turned into water, completely melted down there. And she took the form of a river, Biraja river. And Radharani went inside. When Radharani went inside, then she did not find Krishna or Biraja there. Then Radharani thinking, what happened? Where is Krishna? Where is Biraja? And she knows good astrology. Radharani knows very good astrology also. So through astrological calculation, that she found, when Gaudiya Mutha Maharaj was telling this, this is not in the book, she found that Biraja, she has transformed to river, and Krishna has transformed himself to a snake and hiding inside the river. Then Radharani realized that Krishna is then the form of snakes. So then Radharani took the form of a peacock and standing at the bank of the river, okay, when you come out, I'll catch you. So that Maharaj was telling, that is the reason why Krishna loves so much to put peacock feather on his head. As I told, in Bengal, when we give some class, we give class, Gita, Bhagavad, something. And some Bengal audience, some old man will come. I don't know how much he would be hearing my class or not. But he has some question. He has some specific questions. Wherever you go, Bengal, they'll ask, who is father of Jagai Madhai? Or who is mother of Sukadeva Goswami? Something that you can't answer. No. Very expert people. No. The old people will come up to make a fool in front of everybody. So this is a common question they'll ask. Okay, Maharaj, tell us, why Krishna puts peacock feather on his head? I do not know the answer. So then I just give some answer. So what Krishna will put? He'll put crow feather or what? What is wrong with peacock? Because they're very nice. Why should he put crow feather? I just bluff them telling like this. But this Maharaj said, Krishna is fond of peacock feather because Radharani took the form of a peacock. That time, the peacock feather fell, then Krishna picked up that. Radharani, after some time, she left. Then Krishna picked up that feather and put on his head. So he loves peacock feathers. Then Radharani left to her kunja. Then Radharani very angry. And Radharani told Lalita, Visakha, don't allow him, he comes. Don't allow him to make kunja. Very angry. And after some time, Krishna went with Sridham. to meet Radharani, Lalita, Vishakha, all Sakhi guarding, you cannot go inside. Then they are abuse, they are revoking Krishna. Go, go, get out from here. You have so many gopis to meet with. Go. Now, you develop your love with a river. Let the whole universe know the Supreme Personality of Godhead has a river lover, beloved. So all kinds of teasing, very teasing, no? What Krishna can do? He says, no, please allow me, let me once see Radharani. But they are rebooking, no, get out from here, this, that. He says, no, if I don't see Krishna, I don't see Radharani, I can't survive, please show me Radharani. And they went inside to pacify Radharani. But she's very stubborn. Don't allow him inside. Let him stay out. And she also gave another big song, how Krishna should go stay with Viraja. Then Lalita Vishakha came. Oh, Krishna, Radharani is very stubborn. She's not listening. You do one thing. You go to the next room. You just wait for some time. We'll pacify her, then we'll call you. And all these things Sridham is watching. And he's watching and boiling inside, angry and angry, angry. Then when Krishna went to the left, to other room, and Sridham bursted in anger. Do you dare to treat my Lord Krishna like this? You know you are so great because of my Lord. You dare, you can't tolerate separation for few moments. For some time Krishna went to take service from Viraja, and you can't tolerate that. So I curse you, that you have to tolerate, you have to go through a separation from Krishna for 100 years. Sridham cursed Radharani. And Radharani also became very angry. That you are always supporting your father, never you support your mother, you are like a demon. You are behaving like a demon, so I curse you, we become a demon. You go to the earthly planet and you become a demon. Sridham said, you go to earthly planet, you become gopi. You take birth in cowherd, as a cowherd girl, and each other cursed each other. But you should not think, oh, Golok Vrindavan, they are also becoming angry. They are also cursing each other. But that anger, can you put up this fan? And that anger, and that curse, that does not arise as Bhagavad Gita Krishna saying, Kamayasa, Krodhayasa, Rajaguna, Samudbhava. It's not that. That anger is not coming from Rajaguna, mode of passion. There is different reason why they behave like this. Just like Jaya Vijay, Chatush Kumar cursed Jaya Vijay. Then after cursing in Vaikuntha, they also cursed Jaya Vijay. But after cursing, they went to both groups, both parties, they realized, oh, why you did like this? They would do Narayan, please excuse us, we made a big mistake. Narayan said, no mistake. Now don't put up all the fans, only my fan. You remain cool, no problem. So that I can understand. AC is on, okay. And that's why I'm feeling too cold. So then Narayan said, oh, no problem. Actually, all these things, I'm going to go to exit my pastimes in earthly planet. I made it to curse to behave like this. The same way when Sridham and Radharani cursed each other, then they realized, oh, we did a big mistake. Why we did like this? The next room, Krishna is sitting there peacefully. And he knows what will happen. They all will come to me anyway. So no, but he's sitting peacefully. So both Radharani and Sridham went crying to Krishna that we did like this. No, what to do? Then Sridham said, oh, I am going to become a demon. And then Radharani saying, I am going to become a cowherd girl, going to Marthal planet. How can I go there? And Krishna smiled. Krishna said, no, don't be worried. Because I have to go. You know, one day of Brahma, once I have to visit earthly planet. So that time has come. So I just creating an excuse so that I can go to the earthly planet. So this is the preparation took place in Golok Vrindavan. In Garga Sanghita, Garga Muni describing, when one kalpa, when Krishna will come prior to that, once Brahma, Vishnu, Maheshwar, all of them, they went to Golok Vrindavan. Shiva, Indra, some demigods also, there is a hole. There is a hole through Biraja river. When Vamanadeva lifted his feet through his toe, he made a hole. So through that hole, they went beyond Biraja river. And far, they saw very beyond Biraja river, this huge light dazzling like anything. They could not see anything. After long endeavor, then they could see this huge serpent, Anantasesa. And between Anantasesa, they could see the Golok Vrindavan. And they looked back to Biraja river, and there saw thousands, millions of billions of Brahmandas. They're floating like a small ball. They're floating in Biraja river. From there, they went to Golok Vrindavan. When Golok Vrindavan there, the thousand petal lotus flower is there. In the middle of thousand petals of lotus flower, there's one lotus flower with 108 petals. And middle of that lotus flower, there's one lotus flower with only 8 petals. And they had to cross 8 doors to go inside. All very strong personalities, they're standing as guard. But all these great personalities, they have come. So they allowed, then they all went straight to Krishna. Krishna is there inside. Then they told Krishna, all the problems going on in material world, my lord, you have to come. Krishna smiled, said, yes, I know all these things happening. So very soon I will come. And when Krishna desiring that he will come, and Brahma, all these demigods waiting there, then they saw Sahasra Sirsa Vishnu came and merged into Krishna. Then Ramchandra came, merged into Krishna. Narayana came, merged into all many, many incarnations. They all came and merged into Krishna. And Krishna gave this message to all Golok Vrindavan Vasis. Now it is time I'll go to earthly planet to have my pastimes. All Golok Vrindavan Vasi, they're thinking whose term will be this time they can come to earthly planet. Why they want to come to earthly planet? More enjoyment here. More happiness than Golok Vrindavan. Huh? Yes, there is something special here that Golok Vrindavan they don't have. Golok Vrindavan, nice sweet pastimes of Radha Krishna, Jholan Jatra, Ras Lila, everything is there except one festival. It is not there. You know, Janmashtami. They have no Janmashtami festival there. The Krishna never took birth there. That's why Krishna is Aja. All these Mayavadis, they say, Shastra Veda says, Parambrahma is Aja. Ram took birth. Krishna took birth. How they can become Aja? They can become Parambrahma? They are not Parambrahma, Mayavadis say. But Prabhupada is saying, yes, Krishna is Aja. He is Aja. He never takes birth. But he never takes birth in Golok Vrindavan. That's why he is Aja. And all Golok Vrindavan bus is waiting. When we will have a chance, we can attend the Janmashtami festival there. And I have heard also, in Golok Vrindavan, Krishna, he is always there in his Kishore form. He is never in a small baby form there. He had baby form, naked Krishna. You don't see naked Krishna in Golok Vrindavan. So all these childhood pastimes, all these things, it takes place in this earthly planet. So it is a everybody, so Krishna announced, now I am ready, I will go to material or earthly planet, I will exhibit Bhauma Lila. So everybody preparing to come. Then Radharani heard, everybody going, Krishna also going, Radharani came, you are going to earthly planet? Then how can I stay here? No, no, you please come. No, no, I don't go there. So why I am coming, you will not go? No, I don't go there because there is no Jamuna, there is no Giri Govardhan, no Vrindavan. That's why I will not go. And Krishna said, no, 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 I will bring all these things for you to earthly planet. As I told yesterday, when Lord comes, he comes, Sri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Jibedaya Kare, Sa Parsada Siyodhama Saha Abhatare. When he comes to this earthly planet, he comes along with the Dham. The Govardhan came from spiritual world. The Govardhan is known as Govardhan here. But there, Govardhan is known as Satasingha Parvata. Once Radharani told Krishna that please make a place for me that exclusively I can serve you. And Krishna felt very compassion. He looked at his heart chest and immediately a very dazzling something came out of his heart. It fell on the ground. And that one started to grow, growing. Most of Golok Vrindavan covered. Then Krishna said, hey, stop growing. You will take over everything. Then he stopped. That is Satasingha Parvata. Krishna said, I will bring the Satasingha Parvata to Athil planet. You know that how Giriraj Govardhan appeared, Jamuna appeared, all this Ganga, Jamuna, Saraswati. They all first manifest in spiritual world. Saraswati Devi manifested from the tongue of Krishna. She manifested initially there. Ganga Devi also manifested in Golok Vrindavan. One day Lord Krishna, when having sweet pastimes with Radharani, he was sweating, so much sweating. All sweat collected in one place. From the sweat, beautiful Devi appeared. So that is Ganga Devi. She appeared from the sweat of Krishna. And covering her face, she was wearing very thin silk sari. Covering her face, from inside she is looking Krishna like this. You know, very, you know, enjoying, oh Krishna. And all of a sudden Radharani reached there. Then Radharani saw Samudiji sitting in front of Krishna and looking at him like this. Hey, who are you? Because Radharani never saw. Who are you? Then Ganga Devi became so scared to see Radharani. Immediately she entered the toe of Krishna. She wanted to hide somewhere. So she could not find any place. She entered the toe of Krishna and hiding there. Then Radharani searching. Where is she? Then Radharani knows she is in the form of water. Then Radharani drank water. She drinking all water in Golok Vrindavan, she drank everything. All in Vaikuntha, in heavenly planets, earth, everything water, whole Brahma, all water she drank everything. Then all universes, everything, big problem, all Muni, rishis, they can't take bath, no tarpan, what to do? They all ran to Golok Vrindavan. Brahma, Vishnu, Brahma, Shiva, they all went to Golok Vrindavan. Krishna, Trahi, please save us. Then Krishna said, what is happening? Everything is okay in the Brahmanda. Hey, everything is okay, but we have no water. What happened? All water disappeared. Then Krishna smiled, said, yes, Radharani drank all the water. And because the Ganga Devi appeared and she is hiding here, Radharani is very angry. All if you go and pray Radharani, if Radharani will give abhay, you know, fearlessness, she will come out of my toe. Then Brahma, Shiva, they all went and prayed Radharani and cooled her down, pacified her. And then Radharani said, abhay, give abhay, okay, fearless, you come out of the toe. And when Ganga Devi came out of the toe, then Ganga Devi approached Krishna, said, please accept me. Krishna said, No, I can't accept you here. Radharani is here. But you can get me. You go to Vaikuntha. I am there also. I am then in the form of Narayan. So there you can serve me. Here Radharani is here. You can't stay with me. Then Krishna told Brahma that you take Ganga Devi and I will marry Ganga Devi in another form in Narayan. So that time, Brahma put some Ganga water into his kamandola. That time, Shiva also put some Ganga water on his jata, carrying from there. Then all came to Vaikuntha. Then Vaikuntha, then Brahma gave this proposal to Narayan, that Krishna has told, now this Ganga Devi is here, that you have to marry. So Narayan married Ganga Devi. How many wives Narayan has? Krishna has only 16,108 wives. How many wives Narayan has? Has 4 wives. Lakshmi, Saraswati, Ganga, Tulasi. 4 wives Narayan has. Then Ganga from Golok Vrindavan came to Vaikuntha. Then from Vaikuntha she came to heaven. From heaven she came to Arthil planet. From Arthil planet she went to Patal Loka. So this is Brahma. Ganga Devi is like this. All pervading Ganga Devi. So all these rivers, Saraswati, Ganga, Jamuna, they're all pastimes like that. How they appeared there. Very interesting. Everything that we see here, including day, night, evening, everything has appeared. They have a swarup there in the spiritual world, in Golok Vrindavan. The first manifest there. They're linked with spiritual world. So all these rivers, they have appeared for the pastimes of Krishna, and Shastra says, 5,000 years past Kali Yuga, all Grama Devata Puja will stop. 10,000 years Kali Yuga pass, all these rivers will go back to spiritual world. Actually, when Krishna left the planet, all Ganga, Jamuna, Saraswati, Narmada, they took form and approached Krishna, that please, we want to go back with you also. Because now you are leaving this earthly planet, Kali Yuga coming, and everybody will do so much sinful activities, and take bath in your water, and how can we tolerate so much sin? So we want to go back with you to Golok Vrindavan. And Krishna said, no, you will stay behind. You wait here for another 5,000 years. Then there will be devotee Vaishnavas all over the world. They will all come. From all over the world, Vaishnavas will come and take bath in your water. They will all chant, Hari Bol, Hari Bol, Hari Bol. So in this way, you can spend time with them for another 5,000 years. So that is what Prabhupada has done. Bringing devotee from all over the world, Krishna had predicted 5,000 years ago also. The devotee will come from whole world. So in this way, Krishna told Radharani, I'll bring everything to earthly planet. You please come. Then Radharani said, yes, I will go, but if I go there, then I don't want to see the face of male personalities in this material world. Unless I see you first, I will not go there. That is the reason all of you must have heard why when Radharani appeared, she appeared blind girl. She was blind. Yeah. Now when Narada Muni came, Narada Muni went to Golok Vrindavan after Krishna took birth. Narada Muni found whole Golok Vrindavan very pale. Everything very slow. Then Radharani, what is happening? Why everything is slow over here? Everything looks very pale. Then they said, no, Krishna has gone to earthly planet to have his pastimes. Then Narada Muni came to Nanda Maharaj's house. And Narada Muni saw the baby Krishna in the naked form. And he's very happy to see the Supreme Personality of Godhead, the controller of everything, the baby form is lying there. Very interesting for devotees to see. And after seeing that, then Narada Muni thought, if Krishna has appeared, then definitely the Golokeshwari Radharani must have appeared somewhere. Let me go and search for Golokeshwari Radharani, where she has appeared. I want to see her baby form also. Then Narada Muni was going from house to house, house to house. Oh, anybody has taken birth in your house? Then they bring their baby, not this one. They go next house. Then finally, he came to house of Vrishabhanu king. This Vrishabhanu king, who is Vrishabhanu king, you know? He's Surya Deva, Surya Bhagavan. Surya Bhagavan, he went through severe austerities. And Lord Srihari appeared in front of him. Said, what can I do for you? I am very pleased with you. Ask any boon you want. Then Surya Bhagavan told, please bless me. I can have the Golokeshwari, your eternal consort, as my daughter. The Krishna has told Tathastu. Actually, Lord, he fulfills desire of thousands of people in one activity. It's all interlinked like that. That Surya Bhagavan, he appeared as Vrishabhanu. In Ravel, there is a Brihat Bhanu. So Brihat Bhanu has five sons. Mahabhanu had five sons. Ratna Bhanu, then Vrishabhanu, Subhanu, Prabhanu and Chandrabhanu. So Chandravali is daughter of Chandrabhanu. And Radharani is the daughter of Vrishabhanu. Bhanu, you know meaning of Bhanu? Bhanu means Surya, sun god. So it's Vrishabhanu. He was blessed by Lord Srihari to get the Golokeshwari as his daughter. So Narada Muni went to Vrishabhanu's house. So I want to see, you have any son or any child you have? Then Vrishabhan brought, he has a son, Sridham, very beautiful looking, nice, strong boy. He brought Sridham. So Narada Muni is very happy to see Sridham. Because he is eternal associate of Krishna. Then Narada Muni told Vrishabhanu that you take care of him very nicely. He is a very important personality. You would serve him nicely because he will help in Krishna's pastime. Then Narada Muni blessed Sridham. After blessing Sridham, then Narada Muni was just about to leave. Then Vrishabhanu king said, "Oh Narada Muni, wait a minute. Actually, I have another child. But she's blind. I'll bring her to you if you can bless her so that she can see everything." Then Vrishabhanu king took Narada Muni inside. When Narada Muni saw the beauty of that girl, so beautiful. I have explained to you the beauty of Radharani yesterday. No? I told you, no? Where you are? That one. Okay. So Radharani's beauty is like that. I was telling yesterday that Prabhupada said the most beautiful lady of this earthly planet, Miss Universe, the most beautiful lady, if you compare to her beauty to the beauty of the ladies of heavenly planets, she will look like a frog. Then the lady of heavenly planets, very beautiful. But Lakshmi Devi, 100 times more beautiful than the ladies of heavenly planets. And Prabhupada is saying the gopis of Golok Vrindavan, 1,000 times more beautiful than the ladies are Lakshmi Devi of Vaikuntha. Just imagine Radharani must be much more beautiful. So how much beautiful she would not be. So when Narada Muni saw that, then she said, I have never seen such a beautiful girl. She was very surprised. She was glorifying. She was very surprised to see such a beautiful. Then she realized, she must be the Golakeshwari. Otherwise, how can she be so beautiful? When she was meditating like this, and glorifying Krishna. She was glorifying Krishna. When Radharani heard the glorification of Krishna, she could not control herself. Then immediately she manifested her youth form. And then Narada Muni saw that youth form of Radharani. Then Narada Muni is thinking, "Oh, I have never seen such beautiful. I have seen Parvati, the most beautiful lady of the whole creation. She is nothing. Her beauty cannot touch the beauty of Radharani. I have seen Lakshmi Devi. Her beauty cannot be compared to the shadow of this Radharani, this girl." So she's comparing everything and looking Radharani. Then immediately he fainted by seeing the beauty of Radharani. Then immediately all the gopis are also manifested with Radharani. They washed Radharani's lotus feet and sprinkled water on Narada Muni. Then Narada Muni came back to external consciousness. And all the gopis said, "Oh Narada Muni, she is very flickering. She may disappear any moment. Immediately you should circumambulate and offer your obeisances." So Narada Muni just circumambulated as soon as offered obeisances. Then Radharani became a small baby again. Then Narada Muni offering obeisances, praying prayers. In the Vrishabhanu was not there, he was outside. He put Narada Muni, he left. Then when Vrishabhanu came back, Narada Muni offering obeisances. Then, "Hey, what are you doing, Narada Muni? Why are you offering obeisances to my small baby?" Then Narada Muni says, "Yes, you have a small baby girl, but you don't know who she is. One day you will understand who she is. Take care of her very nicely." Then Narada Muni was very happy, in very jubilant mood. Then Narada Muni, he left. The next pastime, most of you must be hearing, all over the world, they said this pastime, that how, when this news spread, that Vrishabhanu and Kirtida, they have a very beautiful daughter, and everybody, they're going to see the daughter. Then Yashoda Mata also came with Krishna to see the daughter of Vrishabhanu and Kirtida. Then when they meet, Jashoda and Kirtida, they are just discussing. Then Kirtida is saying, just see, I have very beautiful daughter, but so bad fortune, she cannot see, she is blind. They are discussing. And Krishna went crawling. Where Radharani, she was lying on the swing, she was lying there. And Krishna pulled the swing, looked her like this, and touched her. Then Radharani realized Krishna is here. Then immediately she opened eyes, her eyes. Then when Jasodama went to, hey, where is Krishna? Then he went to search for Krishna. Then she found Radharani, eyes open. Then Jasodama, hey, Kritita, you said your daughter is blind. But she eyes open. Then everybody very happy. Then one Vaishnava was telling, actually what happened? And Mother Jasoda carrying Krishna went to see Radharani, baby Radharani. Then when she went to Kritadas' house, she saw Radharani. Then she left Krishna on the ground and picked up Radharani on her lap. Then when she picked up Radharani on her lap, then Krishna started to cry. Then why you are not picking me up? Then Mother Jasoda, she has Radharani and she picked up Krishna also. And the tendency of the small children, they see each other, they touch each other, no? That's why Krishna, he touched Radharani and Radharani could smell of Krishna. Radharani's senses are very sensitive. Very sensitive specifically for Krishna. She could understand, oh, Krishna is here. Then immediately she opened her eyes. So there are many other childhood pastimes. This is one childhood pastimes. So now I will go to tell you one Pauganda pastime. What is Pauganda? In English, Pauganda. 5 to 10 years Pauganda pastimes. So what happened? One day, Krishna told Radharani, Radharani, I love you so much. You are so great. Anybody serves me, I am not happy. Just by serving you, I will be happy. He is glorifying among all the gopis in Vrindavan. You are the topmost, you are the best. Everyone under you. So when Krishna is glorifying Radharani, at one point, Krishna said, you are so great, you are greater than Mother Jasoda also. Then Radharani said, I don't talk too much. You are a bluffer. You are a debauchee. You just talk sweet, sweet words. How can I believe? How can you say, you are telling I am greater than other gopis, okay. But well, I am greater than Mother Jasoda. Huh? How can I become greater than Mother Jasoda? Mother Jasoda is so great. I worship, I am her daughter. I worship her. And you are telling I am greater than Mother Jasoda. And Krishna says, you don't believe this? Very soon you will see that you are thinking, you are worshipping Mother Jasoda, but very soon you will see Mother Jasoda will come and catch hold of your feet. Then Radharani did not believe, that cannot happen. Then Lord Krishna, he arranged one pastimes. So one day, all the gopis with Radharani took Krishna and they all made Krishna to dance. They are dancing. Then Mother Jasoda came. And Mother Jasoda saw the gopis making Krishna to dance. Then Mother Jasoda said, hey, what are you doing? My son Gopal, Krishna, whole day he go for grazing cows. He's so tired, he needs some rest. And you are bringing him and making him to dance like this. And every day you are doing like this. What nonsense are you doing like this? No? Then all gopis, they kept quiet. Then Radharani said, hey, Mother Jasoda, yes, he is Krishna, but you have a son, Krishna also. But does that mean you have Krishna? Because there is no other boy like name of Krishna. We have our Krishna, you have your Krishna. Then Mother Jasoda said, yes, there could be many boys in the name of Krishna, but this boy exactly looks like my son. His face, his body, his behavior, everything like my son. Then Radharani said, no, this is our son, this is our Krishna, this is not your Krishna. You go, your Krishna must be sleeping in her house. Then Mother Jasoda went to her house. Then he went inside the house. She saw Krishna is lying on the bed. She was very surprised. She could not believe, both look same. Then Mother Jasoda came back to Radharani and all the sakhis. So, yes, my Krishna is sleeping there. And your Krishna looks exactly like my Krishna. So it will be very nice. Why don't you bring your Krishna to my house so both Krishna can dance together? And later on, they can be friend to each other. So it'll be very nice. Please bring your Krishna also. So all the Sakhis said, yes, let us go bring this Krishna also. But Radharani became very grave. Radharani said, no, that cannot happen. Radharani said, Mother Yashoda, because your Krishna, our Krishna looks exactly similar. What if it happens, your Krishna and our Krishna will be exchanged? So then Mother Yashoda said, so what is the problem? They are all same. Then Radharani said, no, they are not same. Your son Krishna is a cowherd boy. All day he go for grazing the cows. He does not know any prema rasa. He doesn't know prema tattva. He knows nothing about prema. He's a useless fellow. And our Krishna, he knows prema. He's so powerful. All muni rishis, they are worshipping him. Our Krishna killed so many demons. He's so powerful. Then Madhura Yashoda said, but my Krishna also like that. My Krishna killed Putana, Aghasur, Bakasur. My Krishna also did the same, all these things. My Krishna, Shiva is coming, Brahma coming, worshipping. So what is the difference, your Krishna and my Krishna? Then Radharani said, okay, Madhura Yashoda, if you argue too much, there will be big fighting. So let us stop that. But let us do, I'll do one thing. Better I put a mark on the head of my Krishna. So that will not be exchanged. Then she put a mark here on Tilak, and she put a mark, a Tilak mark on forehead of her Krishna. Then they went to Mother Yashoda's courtyard. Then they started both Krishna dancing. And all are enjoying, all Sakhis, Gopis, they are all enjoying. They're dancing. At one point they become very tired. At one point, both Krishna merged and became one Krishna. So the game is finished. So Radharani got hold of one her Krishna. Said, Mother Yashoda, thank you, we are going. Mother Yashoda said, where is my Krishna? Said, who don't know your Krishna? You see, our Krishna has a mark on his head. That is the reason I put a mark on his head. So we are going. No, bring my Krishna. Where is it? You are hiding. You are a very tricky girl. I know very much. You are hiding somewhere. But what I am hiding is all surrounded by wall. I never went anywhere from here. I am here. Where can I hide your son? Then Mother Yashoda started to cry. No, you must have done something. You are a very tricky girl. Hey, Radharani, I don't have 5 or 7 sons. I have only one son. Please do something. Don't do like this. Don't harass me like this. Then her issue was very miserable condition, Mother Yashoda. Radharani, after compassion. So look, okay, Mother Yashoda, you may do one thing. She was like this, as if she will leave body. Now I leave my body because my Krishna is not here. Then Radharani, looking at Krishna, said, Krishna, what to do? Now your mother is going to die, leave her body. Then Krishna indicated. Then Radharani said, oh, Mother Yashoda, maybe you can check, maybe Krishna dancing, your Krishna dancing too much and become very tired sleeping in your house. Then Mother Yashoda went, in the meantime, what did Mother Yashoda? Said, Radharani, please give my Krishna. Then she cut hold of Radharani's feet. Please do something for me. Then Radharani said, hey, you are my mother, I am worshipping you. Why you are catching my feet? It will be great offense for me. Then Mother Yashoda said, no offense. If you want to become free from offense, then bring back my son Krishna. Then Radharani said, okay, you go to your house. Maybe Krishna is very tired and he's sleeping there. Then Mother Yashoda went. Then Mother Yashoda saw that Krishna is very tired and lying there on the bed. Then Mother very affectionately picked him up and embracing and kissing. Oh my Krishna. As if she got his life back. So this is one of the Pauganda pastime of Srimati Radharani. So I will tell you one pastimes, youthful pastimes. In youthful pastimes, there are many pastimes took place when Radharani was in Barsana. In Barsana, then many youthful pastimes when Radharani went to Javat after marriage. So I will tell you one or two youth pastimes. So you have to prepare to digest these pastimes. You can all digest. How many of you have heard my yesterday class? Very few. Many you have not heard. Usually I don't tell these pastimes unless somebody here That explanation I gave you yesterday. So, Krishna's pastimes are very interesting, very humorous also. Why these pastimes are like this, I'll describe to you at the end of the pastimes. Out of many pastimes, one humorous pastimes I'll describe to you as described by Srila Vishwanath Chakvadipad. Once Radharani, after marriage, so Radharani, she was very angry with Krishna. For some reason, she had mana, very spiritual anger. So she did not want to see Krishna, to meet Krishna. And Krishna was feeling very much separation from Radharani. So unbearable for him. So many ways Krishna trying to pacify Radharani, but Radharani's anger will not be pacified. Then Krishna was feeling very bad, very sad. One day, Krishna went to one of his sister-in-law, Kundalata. Her name is Kundalata. Then Krishna said, Kundalata, oh my sister-in-law, just see, this Radharani is very angry upon me. So many ways I tried to pacify her, but I have failed. But I can't survive without her. Please do something for me. Then Kundalata, out of affection for her son-in-law, said, okay, Krishna, you don't be worried. I will arrange some other, that you can meet Krishna. Krishna will be, Radharani, she will be pacified. What I do, I will dress you as a singer, as a lady singer. So your name will be Kalabali. So I will bring you to Radharani, so you can please Radharani in that way. So Kundalata, she dressed Krishna, blue Krishna with very nice sari, very beautiful lady, beautiful girl, you know. Blouse, saya, sari, all earrings, everything. She looks very beautiful, blue girl. Her name is Kalabali. Then Kundalata went to Jabat. Then Kundalata met Lalita. Then Lalita brought Kundalata and Kalabali. You know who is Kalabali, right? Krishna, Kalabali. To both of them, to Radharani. Then Radharani said, oh, Kundalata, you are all of a sudden, you are here today. What is the reason? Then, wow, you have such a beautiful girl with you. I have never seen this gopi before in Vrindavan. Where she has come from? No, she look, by seeing this beautiful girl, I am feeling very much blissful. Where this girl has come from? Then Kundalata said, yes, this girl, she's a very good singer. She's expert. She sings so beautifully. She will defeat even a Brihaspati. So I brought her. She, by hearing her glories, she wanted to see you. And she has come to see you. And she's so good singer, she can defeat Brihaspati. And Radharani said, really? So where did she learn so nice singing? Then Kundalata said, she learned this from Brihaspati, Devaguru Brihaspati. Devaguru Brihaspati lives in heaven. How did she learn? No. The Brahmanas of Mathura, they had arranged one program, so they invited Devaguru Brihaspati to sing in that program, in that function. And Devaguru Brihaspati was singing. And during singing, Devaguru Brihaspati sang one song with the lady voice. And next day, this Kalabali could exactly imitate that. And when Devaguru Brihaspati heard Kalabali singing such sweet voice, then immediately Devaguru Brihaspati told somebody, please bring that girl. How can she sing so nicely? She has so sweet voice. I chanted, I am from heaven. I chanted at once by hearing my song. She can imitate this. I want to teach him Gandharva Vidya. Gandharva songs. For 1 month, Brahma was, Devaguru Brihaspati was here in Mathura, and she was teaching this girl, Kalabali. Then she became so affectionate to her, she took her to heaven. For 1 year, he was teaching. Just yesterday, this girl came back from heaven. So as soon as she came back, she wanted to see you, and she is here now. You just listen her song, then you will understand how good singer she is. Then Radhani said, yes, my dear Sakhi, please sing some song. Then Kalabali said, what song you want to me to sing? Then Radhani told some Pradusha, this, some song this. Then she said, okay, I will sing this song. Then Radhani said, no, without Bina, this song will not be nice. So you just sing this song for me. Then Kalabali, Krishna in the form of Kalabali, he started to sing that song. And when Krishna started to sing this most very melodious song, and all the Sakshi and Gopi just stunned with wonder how sweet it is. And they become so much impressed by hearing that beautiful song, that tears started to roll down from their eyes. They're all, whether blinking their eyes, they're simply hearing the sweet song sung by Krishna in the form of Kalabali. And when Krishna was singing, at one point, the tear stopped and tear transformed to, that liquid tear transformed to solid ice balls. And ice balls falling from their eyes on the floor, making a ton, 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 hours like this, making sound like this. So beautiful song, Kalabali started to sing. And Radhan was very impressed. When the song finished, so Radha, oh my Sakhi, you sing so nicely. So Radhan immediately went to embrace. She doesn't know. She thinks it's nice Sakhi. She went to embrace. Then Lalita knows who she is. Lalita, at her ear, so hey, what are you doing? Are you going to embrace her? That is Krishna. That cheater has come in the form of a lady. No, what happened? No, Radharani was very pleased because she sang so nicely. She said, I want to give you some gift. Radharani took her necklace and gave that necklace to Kalabali and going very great happiness. She was going to embrace. And like, hey, what are you doing? That cheater Krishna has come wearing this sari. Then Radharani immediately, she controlled herself. She did not become angry. She controlled and she changed. She's very sharp, Radharani very sharp. Immediately she changed. Then she was just going to embrace, putting their necklace. Then he said, oh, yeah. She made a drama. Yes, Lalita, we are correct. Lalita told she is Krishna, but Radhani changed. Yes, Lalita, you are correct. She is singing so nicely. Just by giving a necklace is not sufficient. I should give all dress, ornaments, everything. No, I should give nice dress also. Then Radhani said, Lalita Visakha, you do one thing. You bring nice sari, saya, blouse, everything. So you take out all her clothes. Put new cloth and put nice garments also for her. Then Kundalata said, no, don't do like this. She's from her prestigious family. How can you change her cloth in front of everybody? Then Kalabali said, no, Radharani, I don't want to change my cloth in front of everybody. You don't need to give me new cloths or ornaments. If you are happy with me, just give me one of your old cloth. I'll go and wear. Then Radharani said, why? What is the problem? We are all... No. Then Kundalata said, she will feel very shy if in front of everybody you change her cloth. Then Radharani said, why? We are all ladies are here. In front of ladies, why should she feel shy? And Radhan said, Lalita Visakha, if she doesn't agree, by force change her cloth. Then Lalita Visakha said, Rupa Manjari, you go bring cloths. No? Then Rupa Manjari went and brought all new cloths. Then Lalita Visakha changing cloths, sari, saya, blouse, brassier. Then two mango fell from the chest of the Lord Krishna. See, he has dressed like a lady, making a breast like that. And well, that fell. And everyone started clapping and laughing. Lalita, Visakha, and Krishna felt so shy, putting her head down now, because he has cut. He is feeling very shy, putting her head down, but he put his cloth in front, on his head. And all Lalita, Visakha, Rupa Manjari, every Manjari, laughing. Then Krishna is thinking, what to do now? I got caught now. I am caught now. He's feeling very embarrassed in front of everybody. Everything exposed. And then Krishna immediately picked up those two mangoes and put on his chest. Now, then he ran to Jatila's room, quarters. Jatila saw, and Krishna is like a lady. And Krishna fell on the feet of Jatila, crying, like this. So Jatila, hey, what happened to you? Then Kalabali is saying, just see, your daughter-in-law, how cruel she is. I am daughter, the Kalabali, she said, I am daughter, his family, I am his, her sister. Is Radharani is my childhood friend. And she married, I came after many years. And she is so cruel. She is not receiving me. She is not smiling at me. She is not embracing me. She is rejecting me. What offense I committed? My childhood friend, if she rejects me, then what is the use of my life? I am going to commit suicide in front of you. Krishna said like this. Then Jatila said, what? Why she is so cruel? Why she is behaving in this way? No, my dear daughter, you don't be worried. I'll bring you to Radharani. I'll counsel, pacify her. I'll explain. She will definitely embrace you, no problem. She will receive you nicely. Then Jatila brought Kalabali and told Lalita, see how your Sakhi is so cruel. How can she do like this? Her childhood friend is here and she has come from so far to see for the first time. And Radharani rejecting, Radha rejecting her. She is not smiling at her. She is not receiving her. She is not embracing. Oh my dear daughter-in-law Radha, how can you be so cruel? You should treat your childhood friend nicely. Radha smiled. Said, yes, yes, mother, you please go. I'll treat her nicely, no problem. Then Jatila said, no, if I go, then you may not treat her nicely. Then Jatila by force brought Krishna and Radharani and made him to embrace each other. Then she told Radharani that she's very sad. Please let her spend the whole night with you. Until she become happy, you keep her with. And Radharani said, yes, no problem. Then Krishna stayed whole night with Radharani and Jatila went to her house. So this is the interesting part of Krishna enjoying with all the gopis. So when I was meditating, I was thinking that this funny pastimes, Krishna dressing as a lady, putting two mangoes to look like a lady, then got caught like this. When you compare that supreme personality of Godhead, how he's such a top position there, and his ansa, that Mahavishnu, Vishnu Mahan Sahya Jasya Kala Vishesa. Vishnu is so Mahan. When we hear all these things, Vishnu is so great. From his hair pores, big Brahmandas are coming. Mahavishnu, Garbhadaksha Vishnu, then Kshirodaksha Vishnu. Then last expansion is Anantasesa. Anantasesa has 1,000 hoods. And he's so big, so great. There are so many Brahmandas lying on his head, he doesn't recognize. He thinks the dust is lying on his head. And that big personality is behaving like this. When you compare it, looks very funny, right? How to digest the supreme personality of Godhead can do like this? But that is the beauty. That is the beauty of the supreme personality of Godhead. Being very informal way. So that is the love. That is the prem. That supreme personality of Godhead, who is so great, he also can be so small also. He can be in such informal way, can be so humorous. So that is the greatness of the loving relations with the supreme personality of Godhead. Karmi, jnani, yogis, normal devotees cannot understand this. Unless somebody develops that unallied loving relationship with Krishna. Just imagine, the supreme personality of Godhead will happen just descent from Vaikuntha, just descent from Vaikuntha, riding on Garuda. He'll just get down in sea beach, in Chaupati sea beach. What will happen? Lord Narayan will come and land in Chaupati beach. What will happen? Whole Bombay Wallahs will come now. Wow, Lord has come. They'll all come and worship. Wow, Bhagavan has come. They'll worship and go back. They'll be very scared. Bhagavan has come. They'll not go close to Bhagavan. That is, Bhagavan sometimes come, so devotees can come more close. So everybody thinks Bhagavan means greater, great, very great. But not necessarily. Bhagavan is greater than greatest and smaller than the smallest. In this material world, everybody wants to become Bhagavan. Everybody wants to become great. Why everybody wants to become great? Because everybody is competing with Bhagavan. Each and everyone wants to become Bhagavan. That's why they want to become great. But we can't, but actually Bhagavan is not Bhagavan because he is the great. Bhagavan is Bhagavan, he is greater than greatest and he is smaller than the smallest also. But we want to become Bhagavan. Bhagavan saying, oh, you want to become Bhagavan also? Okay, you try your best to become great. So we are all trying to become great, but we forget to become small also. So Bhagavan is tricking us. Oh, you can become Bhagavan also. You try your best, how to become great, 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 great. But another side is there. We never try to become smaller than the smallest, but Bhagavan can become smaller than the smallest. So this informal pastimes, actually the great quality of the Supreme Personality of Godhead. So that is the reason why Lord Krishna, he comes and the relationship with the Brajavasis, the topmost loving relationship with Krishna. See, in this way, Krishna having many sweet pastimes with Brajavasis. I have 10 more minutes to tell one more pastime. Huh? Okay. What pastime? I'll tell. So many pastimes. Okay, one small pastime. Once Krishna, for a long time, afternoon we have one more class, right? What time is that class? 1 to 2:30. Okay. I have to save some pastime for that session also. So I'll give some humorous pastime for that time. So now I'll tell you one thing. So once Krishna, for a long time, he has not seen Radharani. But that time what happened, Radharani was married. She was in Jabat. For some reason, she had gone to Barsana. To her mother's house. And Radharani, Krishna had not met Radharani for a long time. So one day, Krishna went to Barsana. So how to meet Radharani? Madharani is in Andar Mahal, inside the palace. So Krishna started playing on flute in the forest. That only Radharani can hear. And Krishna has different sets of flutes. He has Bansi, Murali, and what is there? Benu. Bansi, Murali, Benu. And different size also. The Bansi or flute of Krishna has big history also. Where it appeared, in which yajna, how some portion of that bamboo, where this bamboo appeared, how that bamboo was used for Ramchandra's, that bow, and different things. Then finally Krishna got the last portion as Bansi. Then Bansi, Murali and Benu. Some flute he will play, only Mother Yashoda and the elderly lady can listen. No one can listen. And one flute he has, only Radharani can listen. And flute he has, only cowherd boys can listen. Different flutes he was using. Very expert personality. She knows all mantra tantras, you know, controlling everybody. So he played that flute, only Radharani can hear. Actually, he was making a sound, a peacock. But Radharani realized, it's not peacock sound. That Krishna is calling me. So Radharani left the palace and went searching for Krishna. Then she found Krishna. After a long time, she found Krishna very affectionately. Both of them, they entered into a cave. So inside the cave, they're relaxing. Radharani sat down and Krishna lie on the floor, placing his head on Radharani's lap. And they're having loving talks with each other. Radharani looking at the beautiful face of Krishna and is moving her hand, caressing, moving her hand on Krishna's body. And they're having loving talks with each other. For a few hours they have spent like this. They didn't recognize so much, time already passed, only noon time. Then Kirtida looking, where is Radharani? She did not find Radharani, she became very worried. She went all over the palace. So Radharani is not there. She became very worried for her safety. Then she tried to find Radharani. So following her footstep, Kirtida came searching for Radharani, searching. She is going towards that cave. When she is going towards that cave, Radharani did not see that Kirtida is coming. But Krishna is sleeping on Radharani's lap, putting her head like this. So Krishna can see that Kirtida is coming, that side. But Krishna realizing what to do now. We are inside the cave, and cave has only one way to go out. If there's other way, they could run away other way. But Krishna knows Krishna, the cave has only one way, and if you will come out, then Kirtida will see both of us. So to protect him, so Radharani is cursing, you know. Radharani has not seen Kirtida is coming. Then all of a sudden, Radharani found that Krishna is not there. One peacock is lying on her lap. I said, Krishna transformed himself to a peacock. So Radharani cursing a peacock. I said, what happened? Then after some time, Radharani saw Kirtida. Then she realized what has happened. That Kirtida is coming. Then Kirtida came, hey Radha, what are you doing here? I have been searching for you so long. Nowhere I can find. Radharani said, yes, for so long I am sitting in my room. I was feeling very boring. That's why I came to play with this peacock. having some exchange with peacock. Then Kirtida said, no, it's too late now. You have to eat lunch, prasad. Lunch, then you please come back to your house. Lunch, prasad, that's why you're laughing or what? Yeah, they were all eating prasad also. They would offer. Krishna would get up very early morning. He would do Mangalarti also. Yeah, he would do Narayan Puja. He would meditate on himself. He was behaving like that also in his grihastha life. They're all devoted personalities. So then Kirtida took Radharani and fed prasad to her there in her house. So in the, like this, there are many, many sweet pastimes that will start 1 o'clock. And some more sweet pastimes we'll discuss. If you have any questions in this matter about Radharani, yes. Microphone.
Maharaj, as you have described the pastimes from Brahma Vaivarta Puran, like Ganga's appearance and the demigods going through that hole towards the
Golok, then
how do we understand this demigods going and visiting the Golok, as we understand that, you know, nobody can approach the Golok Vrindavan, especially the demigods, and we see that Brahmaji visiting there, taking the Ganges water in the Kamandalu. So is it like they go back and come and not stay, or is it like they not go, or is this like Puran?
In this case, when they go for some business and business is finished, Krishna said, you go back to your job. You do your job there. If you want to come and stay here with me, you have to do a proper sadhana and come. So in some Kalpa, Purana explains, they go to Golok Vrindavan. Sometimes it explains, the demigods, they go to Vaikuntha. And our Acharya is saying, there is one Vaikuntha in this material world also. There is one Vaikuntha. There is a Brahma. He is living in Brahma's abode, but he has office in Sumeru Parvata. Sometimes Brahma spends time here. Like this, there is spiritual world within material world also. There is Vaikuntha planet. The son of Vaikuntha is Vaikuntha. There is a Vaikuntha planet. Sometimes demigods, they go there. So from spiritual realm, if demigods, they go for some specific business, when that business finish, they again come back. Not like that they will achieve Jadgata Nanivartanta Taddam Taddhama Paramamama, they will not come back. It is not like that. By Krishna's, maybe they are empowered by Krishna. Sometimes the great demigods, they go to see Krishna, they go to see Vishnu. That may be happening like that. You have to understand that way. Like that. Yes? Yes? Extra? Yes, yes. What is that saying? Give her microphone.
On the basis of Radha-Krishna relationships, are we not justifying the extramarital relations which are depicted in TV serials?
You were there in my class yesterday? Were you there? Yes or no?
No, I was not.
So that's why you are asking this question. I have explained all these things and justified about the extramarital? Huh? Extra marriage, a relationship outside marriage life. Relationship outside marriage life. I have explained that. People, they have to come to little higher platform to understand the subtle subject matter. That is the reason we have been instructed not to discuss the subject matter to the neophyte peoples. Unless you understand you are not this body or spirit soul, unless you understand Krishna is the Supreme Personality of Godhead. To justify this topic, many things can be described. I described yesterday that how what is spiritual material world is perverted reflection of spiritual world. What is the topmost thing in spiritual world is the worst in material world. Stealing, having relationship with others' ladies, this parakya rasa also I explained. Very abominable. But case of Krishna is very pure also there. Though there are many things to tell you, but one thing I'll tell, I told yesterday, that how Yogamaya has arranged all these things. Outside marriage relationship. In Golok Vrindavan, all gopis, I have explained to you also, the gopis, Radharani, they are not some ordinary lady or living entities. Their pleasure giving potency of Krishna, they have taken form to give pleasure to Krishna. They are eternally serving Krishna in Golok Vrindavan. Knowingly, Krishna is my husband or my lord. But here, Yogamaya in Bhauma Lila, she creates a situation that externally Radharani, all the gopis, they are marrying to other gopabalakas so that their love for Krishna will be intensified. So with so much obstacles, so much hindrance, they will try to reach Krishna. So there is a very subtle and great philosophy behind it that normally it will be difficult for people to comprehend unless you do some sadhana. But I gave that example also as Prabhupada has given, that people may say, Krishna is doing this outside marriage, having so much fun with ladies. How many ladies he was having fun? You remember from yesterday? Only 1 billion ladies he has. I don't know. Nowadays, one boy, how many ladies you can digest? But Krishna is only 1 billion. That you have to understand also. Some boy come forward, I am influenced by Krishna. Influenced by Krishna, okay, 1 billion ladies are given to you. You play with them. Let us see. So Krishna is saying that, you want to become like Krishna? You want to become Gopijana Ballava? So you become Girivaradhari? Krishna is Girivaradhari? Can you become Girivaradhari? Can you lift Giri Govardhan mountain? Can you lift a table in your finger? Can you become table dhari fast? Fast become table dhari, then talk about Giri Govardhari. You understand? So our acharyas, they have very much justified. Krishna can do. My understanding is, sometimes I also think as you are thinking. It's very interesting, right? We have to hear all these things and we have to see Krishna with 8 gopis, right? And there you have to remain brahmachari, you know, no relationship. So how to manage this? How to make understand? How to understand these things? You see, Krishna's loving affairs justifies, because we are living entities. We are part and parcel of Krishna. We are His energy. He has full authority to enjoy with us. We enjoy with Him. It is bona fide. But if you have a girlfriend, she is not part and parcel of you. That is the reason there is no love. If she would be part and parcel of you, then love is there. And that is the reason why after loving relations, then you get a good kick on your face. That is what happens. If we analyze, we can clearly see the loving affair in the material world. And spiritual world is completely different. It's completely different. But as I said, we are all trying to imitate God. Oh, God is enjoying like this. I will also enjoy like you. We are imitating. We are trying to imitate God. That's why Chaitanya Charitamrita first explains the glories of love. I told first day that only Chaitanya Mahaprabhu spread the glories of Radharani. Our Acharya Singh, jadi gaura na haito, tabaki haito, kamane dharitam de, Radhara Mahima, Prema Rasasima, Jagate Janato Ke. How do I survive? Who would let the people in general the extent of the greatness of love of Smati Radharani to Krishna? So that is the reason Sukadeva Goswami, he explained the subject matter at the end of Srimad Bhagavatam. Prabhupada advising us, we have to go step by step, hearing this Srishti Tattva, all his, that he is Bhagavan, then enter these things, then we can understand about this loving affairs. That is the reason we don't tell in outside world, but because Radhastami, and we want to discuss something, the glories of Srimati Radharani. But that loving relationship between Radha and Krishna is like gold. Loving relationship between, among ourselves is like iron. First thing you should do, satisfy your mind by telling him, by making him understand that Krishna's pastimes is gopis and Radharani. Is bona fide, they are their eternal associates, their eternal consorts. That the part and parcel. And there are Swarup Shakti. They are meant to serve. But only the speciality is, when you are somebody's wife, you know her, your husband, you are serving. That is one kind of love. When there's so much obstacles, you have to overcome your obstacles to show the greatness of your love to Krishna. That's why Yogamaya has arranged all these things. So in this way we understand and we hear the sweet pastimes of Krishna, and thus we enjoy the sweet pastimes of Krishna with Radharani and all the gopis. Okay? Are you satisfied to some extent? Yeah? Thank you so much. You see, what you are saying, that we have gone through also. This concept, this understanding. And when we are going through scriptures, hearing from acharyas, we are trying to explore answer to these things. What doubts rising in your mind, that doubts rise in our mind also. But when you read all this nice logic, arguments and points, then that satisfies us, justifying how bona fide the relationship of Radharani and Krishna. So same way, when people will listen all these logic and arguments of our acharyas, it will be clear to them. Otherwise, in the core of, they may worship Radha Krishna, in the core of their heart, they will be always caring. And they will be always bewildered. How these things happen? Why these things happen? All these things will happen. We may say, oh, Krishna was a small boy, he was playing like, it's not a small boy, he was in Kishore form. It's true. Our loving relationship, Santa, Dasya, Sakya, Vatsalya, Madhur, we have here, all reflection, what is there? But that is in real form. And here is Suda. Adi Rasa. Adi Melos there. We are enjoying. Our Sakha Rasa, Vatsalya Rasa, Madhur Rasa, we are enjoying. But the Suda Rasas, Suda Melos, this perverted reflection of what is happening in Golok Vrindavan, when the living entities, they engage in unalloyed devotional service to Krishna. How Krishna releasing the mellows, the madhurima, in reciprocation of prema, love of living entities. The whole science philosophy is there. That is what Chaitanya Mahaprabhu has taught us. So people, they don't understand, they will be always bewildered. That's why Prabhupada also saying, the pastimes of Krishna and Radharani is very puzzling. And Chaitanya the purport is saying, very puzzling, pastimes of Krishna and Radharani. And as soon as you will think to understand pastimes of Krishna and Radharani in the boundary of time and place, you will be more confused also. Nobody knows how old is Radharani. How she was elder than Krishna. Sometimes she, baby Krishna, she is coming like a young girl. Because their form, sometimes young boy, immediately she can transform to Kishore form. All these things are possible there. But when we try to calculate the activities of the Supreme Personality of Godhead, according to our calculation, we measure, according to our intelligence, we fail to understand. We cannot measure in our way the activities of Supreme Personality of Godhead. Like one example I will give you and finish. There is one old lady. The old lady, she measures whole life she is cooking. She had a lota. She measures how much chawal, how much dal, how much water to cook, how much milk, measuring. One day she wanted to buy some cloth. So nobody was there. She went to cloth shop to buy some cloth. Then cloth wala, she started to measure the cloth by scale. The lady said, what are you doing? I am measuring the cloth. What measuring the cloth? I have brought my lota to measure it. The whole life she is measuring with lota. She has brought the lota, I will measure the cloth and bring. And how can you measure cloth with the lota? It will not fit. So if you insist, no, the way I measure you put, then he put some cloth inside the lota and give to you. Then you get cheated. In the same way, we get cheated when we try to measure Krishna in our lota. So, we have to come out of that. And only we can come out of that, not by our own endeavor, by reading scriptures, by learning mantras, tantras, that we can understand by the blessings of the pure devotees. We do sadhana by their pure sei se ishwara tattva bujhibare pare ishwarer kripales hoyeche jahare. I was telling yesterday, no? Ishwarer kripales. You see, I was telling yesterday, the transcendental subject matters. Through our brain we cannot understand. Dibya jnana hride prakashita. Not dibya jnana brain prakashita. Dibya jnana doesn't mean. So this confusion comes. This kind of confusion comes when we try to understand Krishna through our brain. You understand? But transcendental knowledge manifests within the heart, and that will manifest by the mercy of Sadhu Guru and Vaishnavas. So that is very important factor also. That is very important factor. Otherwise we cannot relate. Always will be bewildered. Why Krishna doing like this? Why Krishna doing like that? Why Krishna is doing like that? How to speak? We will get bewildered. I told yesterday, Brahma also got bewildered. Is that why Krishna is eating? Others, what? Remnant, Jhuta. All demigods, Krishna, Brahma glorifying, oh Krishna, Supreme Personality of God had killed a demon, Aghasur. Then Krishna went and ate the remnants. Brahma is thinking, what this boy is doing? Brahma is Vedagya, you know. He knows Veda. And according to Veda, Supreme Personality of God gets so great. Pure Brahmanas, they take bath, they have to chant a mantra, push this nose, that nose, sit like this. And after that, Brahma knows this. Then Bhagavan will eat. That is what Brahma knows. Veda says, he is Vedagya. Veda never says, Veda, that the Lord eats others' remnants. But Brahma is very bewildered. Just like he is saying, how Bhagavan can do like this? Brahma is, how Bhagavan can do like this? So much so, Brahma called a big meeting. He brought all the demigods. You guys are all bluffed. This boy is not Bhagavan. He's eating others' remnants. So that is the reason, Vedesu Dullabha. adullabha atmabhakto. Brahma Sangita, Brahma saying, Brahma himself admitted, Vedesu dullabha, to understand Bhagavan through Veda is difficult, dullabha. But Vedesu dullabha, adullabha atmabhakto. So by the mercy of devotees, this subject matter can be understood. Not for intelligence or developed brain. Brainy children cannot understand that. good heart children can understand this. Okay? So all we pray, as I told yesterday, to understand God, to understand Radharani. What we have understood, what we are discussing, this is also nothing. What we are talking like small children here. Who can understand God? I told you yesterday, no? Brahma trying to understand God. What he did? You remember yesterday? Brahma, what he did? Brahma, he went through 100 years, celestial years, severe austerities. Finally, Brahma said, oh, Bhagavan, now I have understood you. Then Bhagavan Narayan appeared. Oh, now you have understood me? You understood God? Oh, Brahmaji, what have you understood about God? And Brahma said, I have understood that I can never understand you. So, to understand God, if a bird, what can you understand about the sky? As far as you can fly, what can you understand about God, about Krishna? All the great scholarly people, devotees, they're glorifying Krishna. Oh Krishna, you are so great, so beautiful, your face is like moon. Some other comparison? Like cloud. Or all kinds of, the best thing, isn't it? The best thing, Krishna, you are like this. Then when these devotees, they go back and see Krishna, after seeing Krishna, they feel very shy, ashamed. So what great nonsense I have spoken to the people. I have become very proud, glorifying. The best thing, I have, oh, Krishna is like this, Krishna is like that. But after seeing you, I feel so ashamed. What a great offense I have committed. But after seeing you, now I can understand whatever I have spoken, comparing your beauty, there's nothing in comparison to you. The devotee, they realize. Sometimes when I discuss about Radharani and Krishna, I think Radha Krishna must be watching and laughing at us. Just see this fool sitting and what are they discussing? We don't know. We are just talking, hearing from here and there. Who knows what is happening? They must be smiling and what the fools are discussing. But at least, if we are not pure, even if we are not perfect, we are drawing their attention. Isn't it? I feel like that. The pure devotees, they are great. They draw attention of Krishna. Their mind is fixed. They chant holy name nicely. But our mind is not fixed. We struggle to chant. Isn't it? Prabhupada saying, chant and be happy. Raisan Sankarsanita was telling, chant and struggle, then be happy. It's not just chant and be happy. We really struggle to chant our rounds. I have seen during Gaurapunima time, the devotee, they chant, they fall sleepy. Hare Krishna, no, no, like that. And they fall sleepy, then stand up. And stand up and chant, and they still fall sleepy. Yeah. Sometimes I have seen some of your boys also, they go, they do, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna. They're falling asleep. So, the point is, our mind is not fixed. But definitely Krishna must be watching. Isn't it? Just see this poor fellow struggling so much to think about me. The whole purpose to draw the attention of Krishna, whether the mind is fixed upon Krishna, or you're struggling, beating your head to remember Krishna, Krishna must be recognizing this. Yes, Krishna is a very grateful personality. Whatever we are doing, whatever trouble we are going through, Madhurya Kadambini is saying, when you go back to Krishna, Krishna has recorded everything. Krishna will read, oh, you have done it for me, so much you have mistreated, so much nights you have not slept, you are begging for me, you have deprived of the comfort, everything he records. He's not an ungrateful person. He's a very grateful person. Material world, everybody ungrateful. Have you experienced that? You do so much for somebody. One wrong, you do mistake, he will not look at your face. Doesn't matter how close you are. So much things you have done. But Krishna is not like that. He's very grateful. Whatever we do, he remembers and he will reciprocate. He will tell, oh my dear devotee, you have done for me this, done for me that. So much trouble you have got. How can I reciprocate to you? This is a mentality. This is a mood. Little bit we do, he recognizes that. So that's why he is so great. That's why he is Bhagavan. We are ungrateful. We are not Bhagavan. But he is very grateful. That's his Bhagavan. Okay? Jai Sri Sri Radha Gopinath ki, Samaveta Bhakta Vrinda ki, Nitai Gaura Sitanath Premanande, Hari Hari Bol.
Hare Krishna. So,